I'm sure you'll think of something mutually rewarding.
I was thinking that we need to find the source of King Peter's little toys.
I agree. You have a scheme running around that pretty little head of yours?
If you could bring me a part or two from one of their gliders, I could take it to a fence I know that specializes in high tech.
And he'll be able to tell us the source.
Yes, she will. Then we can go break all the King Peter's stuff.
I like the sound of that. I'll keep my eyes open for any drop parts.
Look at you, Mr. Superhero.
Hey, Felicia.
How do you do it? Go back to being just plain old Peter Parker, I mean.
What?
You're out here in the costume swinging around in your amazing, spectacular, ultimate Spider-Man. But you go home at night and you take off the super duds and you're just Peter Parker.
Do you have any idea how bad I'd smell if I never took off this costume?
I think you're missing my point.
Kat, it should be obvious by now that I'm missing your point.
When you do what you need to do as Spidey, you go back to pretending to be normal instead of being who you are.
I are Peter Parker?
No, you are Spider-Man. Remember that. You deserve a new and better life.
You actually sound a bit crazier than usual right now, Kat.
You'll understand what I mean someday. You'll see.
You're asking me to leave everything behind and just be Spider-Man. What's going on in these high-rise offices?
Kingpin's men are hitting the police in open street battles. You've got to help.
I'll do what I can.
That component you found should lead us right to the source.
Good.
Hey, I got a little tip about something about to go down at the Daily Bugle.
My favorite rag. Okay, what's up?
Kingpin's sending a team there. I don't know the specifics.
And how do you know this?
A little birdie told me.
Cute. Cat caught a little bird.
Little goblin, actually. But he did sing.
Okay, enough of the metaphors. I'm heading for the Bugle.